My name is Jamila Tausif. I am the Programme Director for Integrated Personal Commissioning in Cheshire West and Chester. The cohort we're actually looking at is people with learning disabilities and or autism, and working with our both CCGs, both West Cheshire CCG and Vale Royal CCG, to look at a different offer for individuals with those particular needs. I think if we get it right, we are developing their IPC locally with local people who use the services. So instead of ourselves as a local authority or our CCG colleagues, we're asking individuals, if they manage their own budget and did their own support planning, what would they like us to do to support them to make that happen? So hopefully it will feel very different on the ground and driven by our individuals and families and carers. I think there's the challenges around our contracts and how we commission them, challenges around resource allocation, bringing social care and health funding together, and also some of the workforce cultural changes and the way professionals assess and deliver services. And I think those are the main areas, including the market development, because we actually acknowledge at the moment, because we're somewhere down the line, we've already looked at our cohort of 10, we've assessed them, encouraged them to do their own support planning, and we've found that some of the market isn't quite developed in terms of what they actually want to spend their money on. So we need to look at that, and both between health and social care, how we can deliver that differently. I think where we are with the IPC, if we've done our 10 cohort, we've brought in children and adults within that. And it has been quite difficult, but I think the true essence of personalisation, and we talk about it a lot in social care, less so in health, is we have actually realised that we weren't actually doing personalisation. We were actually leading people to what we felt their needs are. But however, the cohort has taught us that it's the opposite. They are now actually telling us what their needs are and how we can support them to deliver that.
My name's Alison Lee. I'm one of the chief execs on the board of the IPC in Cheshire. Well, I think it's there to make a difference for people with learning disabilities. That's our first group of people we're trying to work with. And really, it's just to make a difference to those people's lives in terms of quality of life, outcomes, and delivering value for money for the taxpayer. I think some of it has been translating it to frontline staff and to people with learning disabilities and their families. I think there's some fear to overcome. Perhaps we've sort of looked after people very well, but we've not empowered them to take responsibility. So I think the first hurdle that we're working on at the minute is making this meaningful to people. We can use a lot of jargon, a lot of acronyms, and to try and sell this really simply to frontline staff. They're as important to me as the people and their families to make this work. Well, I think at the heart of it is people feeling in control, and it is one of the five-year forward view ambitions that we're trying to realise. I think if the NHS and social care system is going to survive, we've got to transfer power to the people, and this is giving power and responsibility to people and their families. I mean, to us, partnership working's at the root of this. It's a real alliance between both the NHS, social care, but people and their families as well. So we're buying in advocacy support to really make sure that people feel in control of their lives. I think one of the other ways we try and bring it to life is to use real examples. So I spent time recently out meeting with people with learning disabilities, and there's a chap called Ray who lives in Chester, whose story I tell. And Ray feels absolutely in control of his life. He chairs the meetings that are about him, and the landlord of the local pub comes to those meetings where they discuss Ray and what makes his life meaningful at the minute. And I think telling those stories has a way of bringing this to life that perhaps the policies just don't. And I think that's one of the things we're really working on hard in Cheshire.